again, make sure you check out my website, ethanwrenn.com. From there, you can find links to all my various social medias. Make sure to follow on YouTube, Twitch, Twitter, Instagram, Reddit, Discord, all the various social medias if you want to stay up to date with all the latest information. We just finished looking at Boohoo Group and the LSE exchange. Now we're going a little more domestic this side of the border. I guess it depends where you're viewing from, but this is Under Armour. Let me do some more analysis here and then we'll get a better picture for where they might be going. Should I turn this light down a little bit? Is it too bright or is it good? Looks like the shadows are a little weird. It's like throwing a Pokeball, right? It is interesting how this Fibonacci circle appears right with the IPO. Is there older price history? I feel like Under Armour has to be an older company than this. As you can see, I had been playing it there for a period in 2018. Thank you. So what do we think? We just looked at Under Armour. Make sure you're following the stream if you're not already. You're slacking. Okay. Under Armour. So this is Under Armour. As you can see, we always talk about how the IPO game is super played out. This is an example of a company 2 or 3 years after its IPO. And it just shows the commonly reoccurring trend that is these IPOs getting super high price tags right out the gate, whatever Wall Street thinks they can charge you for it, and then they are doomed. They basically have nowhere to go from there. The initial public offering price is so high that it only has one way to go. So if you would have strapped in on the IPO day, you could have probably benefited from the 77% move to the downside. From IPO day to current price, we are looking at a decrease of 54.17%. There's no dividend yield. The market cap is $9 billion. That is in US dollars. Let's look at the income statement. So for 2017, they had a profit margin of negative 0.97. In 2018, they had a profit margin of -0.89. In 2019, they had a profit margin of 1.76. And then in 2020, the Corona year, they seem to have struggled a little bit. Their profit margin dipped down to about -12.28%. Kind of makes sense. Overall, I see these main trend lines. You see the green lines at the $6 area, the $5 area. If you guys aren't following, I really don't know what you guys are doing. You're missing out, man. Join the community. We're a family here. That's a lot. My projection for this company would probably be to the downside. If anything, I would have probably wanted to have gotten in short at around that $21 price range area. Max, from top to bottom, you're looking at 58%, give or take. If this downtrending price channel confirms, it could be as much as 80%. If this acts as the support, it could be 67%. But at the general gist is, looking at the RSI, you see it turning over from being overbought into that more oversold territory. So this decrease of buying pressure over time. this isn't a company that's grown since its IPO. It's not like the latest, hottest thing, but it exists. I'd probably expect them to bounce back from this negative 12, this very dishonorable negative 12, but I don't see them necessarily straying too far from the single digit profit margins anytime soon. Guys, make sure to invite your friends to the stream, ask questions. Are there any companies in specific you guys would like me to cover this week for this week's videos? Make sure it gets highlighted for this week. Anything to promote? I haven't heard somebody say a single thing about an altcoin today, which is amazing. Amazing. Let's look at... Man. If you guys aren't familiar, make sure to visit my website, ethanwrenn.com. Right now we are in Discord. From there you can get links to all my various social medias, whether it be Discord, Reddit, Twitter, Twitch. We are live on YouTube, Twitch, Twitter, Face, and DLive. Maybe not Facebook right now, but multiple platforms. Wherever you're watching, make sure you follow to stay up to date with all the latest information. The Discord, you can get a hold of me basically 24/7. I'm always in here. You could actually join right now and talk to me, or if there's anyone you would like to talk to me, they can join. It's public, it's free, and always will be free. We try and be supportive of each other around here. But yeah. So other than Under Armour, what do you guys want to be looking at?